गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। इन
मॉर्निंग मैम,
सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट फ्यू सिस्टम सॉफ्टवेयर्स एज इन कंपाइलर, इंटरप्रेटर, असेंबलर एंड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम। सो लेट्स हैव एन कंप्लीट ओवरव्यू of operating system, what actually operating system is, and what are the various types, like various common operating systems we are having, and what are the functions of operating system. So let's have an overview of operating system. So starting with the discussion, first thing first, about the definition of operating system. So how will you define an operating system? Operating system is basically an it is a software program that act as an interface between user of the computer and computer hardware. So the purpose of operating system is to provide an environment in which a user can execute programs in a convenient and efficient manner. Operating system is a first program that gets loaded into memory through a process which is called booting. Booting maine last session mein bhi aapko bataya tha, jab bhi aap switch on karte ho, power on karte ho apne system ko, अभी आपकी विंडोज लोड नहीं हुई है, विंडोज स्टार्ट नहीं हुई है, उससे पहले ही सबसे पहले जो प्रोग्राम आपका एग्जीक्यूट होगा, दैट विल बी योर बूटिंग प्रोग्राम। सो इट विल एग्जीक्यूट एंड इट एक्चुअली अलाउज, एक्चुअली हेल्प्स योर विंडोज टू गेट लोडेड एंड स्टार्ट योर प्रोसीडिंग्स। सो इस प्रोग्राम को हम बूटअप प्रोसेस भी बोल देते हैं या बूटिंग प्रोग्राम भी बोल देते हैं। So we can say that an operating system is an integrated set of programs that manage the various hardware resources such as processors, memory, input-output devices, communication devices, and the overall operations of a computer system. So its primary objective is to improve the performance and efficiency of computer system and make it user-friendly. So as I have already discussed, operating system always act as the bridge, the interface, or we can say the coordinator between your hardwares, memories, and users. So an operating system also here act as a platform on which various application programs such as word processor or Excel are executed. So whatsoever softwares you are using, it is the operating system who helps you to access or to get your operations done with other software systems as well. So the most common operating systems here nowadays we are having Unix, Windows, Windows 7, 10 or Vista we are using nowadays, then Linux, then Macintosh, Android is also there, Mac. So they all are the operating systems nowadays in trend. Moving on next, how operating systems act as an extended machine. They act as extended machine on certain grounds. Like an operating system is a layer of software on top of your core hardware of computer systems. So this operating system manages all the parts of system and present to the user with an interface or virtual machine. So that is easier to program and to use. because here a user doesn't need to actually aware of the machine codes, rather they can work with their high level language and instruct the hardwares to work according to them. And the interface, the operating systems will translate or communicate on behalf of users with hardwares. So it means that operating system hides the detail of hardware resource from the programmer and provide the programmer with the convenient interface for using the computer system. So this particular process is known as abstraction. Means the user doesn't actually see the whole thing, but an abstract version. So thus the abstraction feature of operating system hides the lower level details from user and provides a set of high level functions to the users. The operating system acts as an intermediate between hardware and its users, providing a high level interface to low level resources and making it easier for the programmer and other users to access and use those resources. So this is the logical architecture of computer system. You can have a look. The hardware resources are surrounded by operating system layer, which in turn is surrounded with the layer of other system softwares such as compilers, assemblers, editors, database, and so on. So actually operating system is here, which is acting as an interface between hardware, the code hardware, and between user or other system and application programs. So it is more closer to hardware, as we have discussed in a previous session. So by a set of application programs such as data processing applications, scientific, engineering application, entertainment and education application, they all coordinate with operating system to get the hardware resources and to get the work done. So thus the purpose of operating system is to present the user with the equivalent of an extended machine, or we can say a virtual machine, that is easier to program than the underlying hardware. So basically operating system coordinate kaise kar raha hai, let's say we are having multiple users here, सबकी अपनी अपनी डिमांड्स होंगी. सो हमारे पास सीपीयू एक ही है, बट कंप्यूटर ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इस तरह से कोऑर्डिनेट करेगा, इस तरह से एलोकेशन एंड डी एलोकेशन करेगा रिसोर्सेज की, कि थोड़ी थोड़ी देर के लिए सबको वो एंटरटेन करेगा, सारे यूजर्स को फैसिलिटेट करेगा रिसोर्सेज के लिए. लेट से यूजर वन को सीपीयू की जरूरत है, यूजर टू को प्रिंटर की जरूरत है. सो वो स्विच करता रहेगा रिसोर्सेज को जब जिसको जौन सी रिक्वायरमेंट है. सो ये कॉन्सेप्ट्स किस तरह काम करते हैं, ये हम ज्यादा डिटेल में अभी आगे आने वाले सेशंस में डिस्कस करेंगे. सो बट द मेन पर्पस ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इज टू कोऑर्डिनेट बिटवीन हार्डवेयर रिसोर्सेज एंड द यूजर रिक्वेस्ट और द एप्लीकेशन रिक्वेस्ट. सो मूविंग ऑन नेक्स्ट, operating system works as a resource management, as I have already told you. So it has to coordinate for managing for allocation and deallocation of various resources. So how it is working as resource management? So computer system usually has many hardware and software resources such as processors, memory, disk, printers, input output devices, etc. And the operating system act as manager of these resources. The operating system is responsible for controlling and allocating various hardware and software resources to different users in an optimal and efficient manner. So the task of resource management becomes essential in multiple user operating systems where different users compete for the same resources. So they are requesting the same resource, then it is operating system's call how to fulfill those requests. As a resource manager, the operating system keeps track of who is using which resource. It grants resource request, it accounting the resource usage, and it also mediating conflicting resources from different programs and users. So how operating system is fulfilling or keeping track of all this we'll be discussing more in more detail. But these are the basic checks that operating system keeps. So operating system manages resources in two different ways. One is time multiplexing and the other is space multiplexing. So time multiplexing is provided by operating system to manage the resources? It basically defines the sharing of resources on the basis of fixed time slices, fixed time slots. Ek particular user ko ek particular time span ke liye hum ek resource dete hain, usse uske baad usse wo resource le liya jata hai. Jaise agar let's say CPU ki zarurat hai ek particular user ko, ek particular task ko, उसको हमने 10 सेकंड के लिए रिसोर्स एलोकेट किया, उसने जितना प्रोसेस करना था किया, बाकी जो पेंडिंग है वो बाद में करेगा जब उसको दोबारा एलोकेट होगा, और 10 सेकंड के बाद उससे सीपीयू ले लिया जाता है और किसी और को ग्रांट कर दिया जाता है. सो दिस इज हाउ टाइम मल्टीप्लेक्सिंग इज परफॉर्म. सो द अदर way in which operating system manages the resources is your space multiplexing. It basically defines the concurrent sharing of resources among different programs. Taking an example, sharing of hard disk and main memory is space multiplexing. So main memory hai, usme kafi space hai, apne slots jo hai divide kar diya hue hain users ko, aur simultaneously कोई भी यूजर अपने पर्टिकुलर स्लॉट को यूज कर सकता है. सो इट इज द वर्चुअल डिवीजन और एलोकेशन. एक्चुअली द मेन मेमोरी इज ओनली वन, हमारे पास मेन मेमोरी एक ही है, बट उसमें से हमने कुछ स्पेस है जो पर्टिकुलर यूजर को एलोकेट कर दिया, वो कभी भी उसको एक्सेस कर सकता है. सो दिस इज मोर ऑफ लाइक शेयरिंग द रिसोर्सेज काइंड ऑफ थिंग. देन वी हैव वेरियस फंक्शंस ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. So the primary function of an operating system is to provide an environment for execution of program or user's program. So however, the task is divided into number of small pieces that perform specialized tasks. Each part has its defined input, output and functions. And the various functions performed by each component is the one is process management. What actually process management is? The process management here refers to the assignment of processor to different tasks being performed by the computer system. The process management here schedules the various processes of system for execution. And the operating system is responsible for various activities in connection with the process management, as in creating and deleting both user and system processes, supporting and suspended and resuming processes, when to start which process, when to suspend which process. They all are being controlled by operating system. Then providing mechanism for process synchronization, such as semaphores. So this particular mechanism we will discuss in very detail. So we have to sync for various process like allocation, deallocation. में आप जब भी resources लेते हो तो process वहाँ पे बंद हो जाता है जितनी processing हुई है. तो उस process को उसी जगह से दोबारा शुरू करना, उसके लिए कौन कौन सी इंफॉर्मेशन आपको चाहिए. सो इसके लिए एक सिंक होना चाहिए. सो उस पे सेमाफोर्स के साथ काम करते हैं. और ये काम कैसे होता है दैट वी विल डिस्कस इन अवर अपकमिंग सेशंस. देन प्रोवाइडिंग मैकेनिज्म फॉर प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेशन. प्रोसेसेस हैव टू इंटरैक्ट विद ईच अदर एंड प्रोसेस कम्युनिकेशन इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. एंड प्रोवाइडिंग मैकेनिज्म फॉर डेडलॉक हैंडलिंग. Deadlock is a condition in which the number of processes wait infinitely for same resource. Let's say एक process है, उसको भी एक वही resource चाहिए, दूसरे को भी वही चाहिए, तीसरे को भी वही चाहिए. So सभी एक ही resource के लिए fight कर रहे हैं, उस case में deadlock लग जाता है और किसी को भी मिल नहीं पा रहा है. So इस mechanism को हम बहुत detail में करेंगे. Afterwards, the next function of operating system is main memory management. So memory is organized as a large array of words or bytes that store the user programs and instructions for execution. The main memory is usually shared by operating system and application programs. The memory manager keeps track of area of main memory where operating system resides and where application programs reside. So in multi-programming environment, several programs or processes are kept in main memory so as to increase the CPU utilization and decrease the CPU response time. The memory management here also implements various protections techniques in order to protect the allocated memory from unauthorized access. And the operating system is responsible for certain activities here in memory management, like it keeps track of which part of memory is currently being used and by which process, and deciding which processes are to be loaded into memory when memory space becomes available, and allocating and deallocating memory space as needed. So all these checks are maintained by operating system. Then the next function here is secondary storage management. Which also included in main memory management as well. So here in this particular scenario, the operating system performs various activities in connection with disk management, as in it free space management. That is, it manages free space on disk by reclaiming memory from used objects. Then storage allocation allocates storage area for storing new programs, and disk scheduling as well. Apart from this, the other function of operating system is file management. So how it is managing the file, like file as we know is a storage unit and is a collection of information, and files are categorized on the basis of information they hold, like data files we have, source files which are our program files, and the object file which are executable files also. So data files represent the information in numeric, alphabets or other symbols, and source files store the code for programs, and object files are built on compiling the programs. So files are stored onto storage device such as hard disk, floppies and CDs, and files are grouped together into directories for users. So operating system here performs various functions in connection with file management, like in creating and deleting files, creating and deleting of directories, then providing operations for manipulating files and directories such as read, write, execute, copy, append. These all are operations supported by operating system for file management. And mapping the files onto secondary storage devices such as disk. So from where to retrieve a particular file, where to store a file, they all mapping is being done by operating system. Then backing up files on stable or non-volatile storage medium so that they can be restored if original file is lost. So backing up process is also managed and maintained by operating system. Apart from this, operating system also helps in input-output management. Like input-output devices are attached to computer systems, are used to enter the data into system and to get the output. So this subsystem manages all the input-output devices and contain a variety of software programs to handle these devices. So this subsystem or the operating system contains a collection of device drivers. The device drivers is a software module that manage the communication and control the specific input-output device. Device drivers actually converts the logical request from the user into specific command that directs the device itself. So this subsystem also implements device allocation policies for each device. Input-output device management subsystem keeps an account to determine which device is allocated to which process. It also looks after the application of devices to processes and reclaim them when processes do not need them. So for device management subsystem, here performing various tasks, as in it keeps track of resources like devices, channels, control units, and this component of input-output subsystem is called input-output traffic controller. It allocates the resources or devices in an efficient manner. If it is to be shared, then decides who gets it and for how long. So it handles the task. This particular handling task is known as input-output scheduling. And it allocates the devices or resources and initiates the input-output operations. Apart from this, the next we have is protection and security, which is also the main function of operating system. So it is like in a multi-programming environment where several users, processes, resides in main memory at the same time, they may interfere with operating system or with each other. So thus here we need to have a protection mechanism which controls the access of users, programs and processes used by various applications. So protection mechanisms are also used here to provide protection to various resources also, like memory segments for files for CPU against unauthorized users. Also, when we talk about security, security deals with protecting the various resources and information of computer system against destruction and unauthorized access. So a total approach to computer security involves both external as well as internal security. And operating system ensures the protection and security function as well. Then we have is networking. So networking is used for exchanging information among different computers that are distributed across various locations. Like nowadays we are having distributed system, and distributed system consists of multiple processors and each processor has its own memory and clock. So the various processors communicate using communication links such as telephone lines or buses, or they are connected by LANs. So these all are supported by operating system. And lastly, we have command interpretations. Command interpretation is the basic interface between the computer and the user. So there are two different user interface supported by various operating system. One is command line interface and the other one is graphical user interface. And what is command line interface? It is the textual user interface in which user gives instruction to computer by typing the commands. And if we talk about graphical user interface, graphical user interface provides the user a screen, the graphics that we are visualizing. Hame jo cheezein screen pe dikh rahi hain, they all are the graphical user interface with some icons or menu, and also the user to make a rapid selection from displayed icons or menus to give instructions to computers. So hame screen pe jo kuch tools dikh rahe hain jo bhi, so they are all are the graphical user interface. So this is all about the functions of operating system. Then we'll be proceeding with our discussion in next session. We are running out of time, so we'll continue the discussion for next session. This is all for today's session.